Now, in the second problem, I would be not doing the whole problem. I'll be just discussing the few items that are slightly different from the first and what's the treatment for the same. Now, in second problem, you have the word written inwards and also written outwards. In the initial chapters, you have learned written outwards is nothing but, this is the second problem. So, written outwards is nothing but purchase returns. Return outwards is nothing but purchase returns. So, what you have to do, it should be written outwards, you have to minus from purchases. Similarly, you have clearing charges. You have your clearing charges, they are direct expenses already in the list. Then you have your return inwards. You have your return inwards. Return inwards is nothing but your sales return. Your sales returns. Sales returns is nothing but return inward. Now, next you have carriage inward. Now, remember, carriage inward is nothing but your direct expense. So, it will be going to the debit side of your trading account. Now, there is mention of freight. That would also be going to the debit of your trading account. Now, coming to the third problem. In the third problem, you have purchases. Now, under actually purchases is nothing but a combination of goods purchased for cash, which we call as cash purchases, and also goods purchased for credit, which we generally called as credit purchases. So what you have to take the purchases in third problem as the combination of your cash purchase plus credit purchase. So your cash purchases are 2,500 and your credit purchases are how much? 8,500. So your total purchases would be 11,000, which you will be taking on the debit side of trading account in inner column and minusing the purchase returns, which is around 750. Then there is mention of factory lighting. We discussed all factory expenses are direct expenses, so we would be taking that also in trading account. Similarly, oil and fuel, because oil and fuel is mostly used in factory, so it becomes part of your factory expense. Then on in the fourth problem, moving on to the fourth problem, the items that you are going to, which are slightly different, are you have your coal and water. Again, coal and water is mostly used in factory. Coal and water is used in factory in large quantities. So, this coal and water you would be taking in trading account on debit side because it would be forming part of your factory expense. Then next is manufacturing expense. The word manufacturing expense itself states that it is something to do with factory. So, manufacturing expenses would also go to your trading account debit side. The next item is, it is given to you as returns in bracket debit balance. Now, if you see this, this should either be purchase returns or sales returns, but recall your basic journal entries, returns, debit. Which return we will write in the debit part of journal entry? Sales returns. So, we know that sales returns account shows debit balance. So, returns debit balance is nothing but representing sales returns, which should be deducted from sales. Similarly, returns which is showing credit balance is nothing but purchase returns, and we know purchase returns has to be deducted from purchases. So, always remember, sales returns shows debit balance, purchase returns shows credit balance. Now, next you are given import duties. Import duties, these import duties would again go to your list of direct expenses. So, I am adding import duties also. So, make a brief summary of your direct expenses, and remember these nominal accounts would be coming in your trading account. Any other nominal account would be coming in your P&L account. We'll move on to P&L in the next class and see how it is prepared.